Hi internet, welcome to my internet. Meet Lauren, my model today. So for today's fake freckled look, I'm going to start cleansing Lauren's skin with Shu Uemura cleansing oil. So make sure you really wipe it onto the face. It will remove any traces of dirt or old makeup and will go deep into the pores to start with a fresh, clean skin. I'm just going to put this all over her forehead, eyes and lashes. And just make sure that the oil is really worked into her skin. What you must remember is that you have to emulsify the oil afterwards to take it off the skin. As a lotion, these days I'd like to use apple cider vinegar. The best one to use is an organic one, which is unpasteurized and unfiltered, and which is really good for your skin because it still has enzymes in it. And I'm just going to spray it onto Lauren's skin to make sure that she gets toned and her pH balance will be renewed. Now what I like to use these days as well is Vita Coco organic raw cold pressed coconut oil. This is good for you head to toe and inside out. Now it's always nice to give yourself a little face massage. Wake up your skin, make sure you get the blood flowing before you apply your makeup. The Vita Coco is also good as a lip balm, so make sure that you put a little bit on the lips. The first thing to do for your beach look is to curl your eyelashes. I really like the Shu Uemura Eyelash Curler. I know it looks the same as all the other ones on the market, but it's really the only one that really works. So make sure when you curl your eyelashes to curl it once really near the lash line and then once a little bit further away, so you get that really lovely nice curl from the sides rather than a kink. Now, because you're going to a beach, you want to make sure that you got a little bit of SPF on your skin. So at the moment, I'm using the Bobbi Brown BB Cream SPF 35. I'm applying this with my Kabuki brush from Sigma Pro. You can just move it down on the skin. Always make sure you go downwards because we all have tiny little hairs on our face. And if we start moving upwards, and turn it all around, you will just move them up and down, drawing more attention to them. So make sure you really buff that into the skin. What you can also do is with a little beauty blender sponge, you can really buff things into your skin. These sponges are latex free, so they're really good and they don't have any ridges. Again, you can move it up and down, you can roll it, and just make sure that everything gets taken to the skin and there's no residue left. So I'm gonna leave the skin quite light and fresh like this. I know Lauren has a little bit of redness on her cheeks, and for this I'm using an Urban Decay skin concealer in the light color. I'm also using another Sigma brush, a small Kabuki one, which is really good concealing in certain places. So everywhere Lauren is red, I'm going to put a tiny bit of this yellow base concealer on just to even out her skin. So I'm just going to conceal a little bit of the under eye. It's a tiny different color. So for this one, I'm using a more pink based color from OCC, which I can then blend in with my tiny micro blender from Beauty Blender. I'm applying the concealer with my brush, which is a Shu Uemura brush. Flat and synthetic, which means that I can really easily go to the places I want to go. And because it's flat, I can kind of tap in the product. Make sure you don't use too much and make sure you just blend it in with your micro blender. So that's me for the skin at the moment. Nice, fresh, healthy and glowing for our first freckled beach look. Because it's just a beach look, I think what we can do is just brush up the eyebrows to give it a nice groomed fresh look. But we don't need to put much product in it because after all we're at the beach. However, if it's very windy on the beach, you might want to put some clear brow set in it. So the one I'm using is from Collection Cosmetics. This is just a little clear brow gel which will keep your brows in place if you want to keep them up all day long. Now what's nice for your freckled look is if you kind of just make your eyes a little bit more open. And we can do that by applying a beige eye pencil. Today I'm using a NARS eye pencil in Larger Than Life, which is a longwear eyeliner. We're just gonna apply this in the waterline, and this beige color will just give your eyes a tiny pop of openness, what you might like. Make sure that your pencil is not too dark or not too pink, otherwise it might make your eye look swollen rather than open. Now I just want to give a little intensity to the eye, and for that I'm going to use a paint pot from MAC in Groundwork. I'm going to apply that with a MAC brush as well, and I'm going to apply it very near to the lash line, and from that I'm going to move up. By using this technique, I can make sure that the product really goes near the lashes, so there's no gaps of skin showing through in between. Blend it away with a blending brush. I'm using a blending brush from OCC. When you do this, you can see it's got a very natural tone or hue to it, like what you might normally find in someone's eye color. Now I think I'm going to just use a tiny bit of pressed powder by Chanel. I like to use it with a smaller brush. This one is from Bobbi Brown. And what I like to do is I like to roll it into the skin just where you need a little bit of powder. This is the point where we were waiting for. We're gonna make some fake freckles. I happen to have a natural brow color from Bourjois in number 23. Which is just a felt tip pen, which makes life really easy. It's quite pointy. So all I need to do is place my pencil or my liquid and dot it on in the places that I want to make little freckles. Now, it's probably good to keep them very random because freckles usually come quite randomly. I'm about to finish my first beach look, the freckled look, and I'm going to do that by just applying a little bit of a skin-colored lip gloss. This one is by Chanel and it's number 51 Insouciance. I love this color because it tends to look really good on everybody. Then to just really finish your look, I'm going to use Convertible Color from Stila Cosmetics in Peony, which is something that you can use on your cheeks and on your lips, but I sometimes even use it on my eyes. It's amazing for just anywhere. It is a cream, so I'm going to use it with a little brush from Shuamura. So as you can see, because it's creamy, it's quite shiny, but that's what we kind of like because we are outdoors, we are on the beach. So there we go. This is your number one fake freckled beach look. You can try it home before going to the beach or before going to that nice beach party. Have fun. Thank you so much for watching my videos and I hope to see you on that beach looking good. Make sure you subscribe to ShopKate's YouTube channel and you can maybe catch me if you can. Bye!